Here we are at Flatstock. Posters everywhere. You know, bands have shows. Shows need to be marketed. Despite the fact that we're living in the digital age, there's some pretty cool analog stuff going on right here. It's not just about getting the news out about your show. This is clearly elevated to an art form of its own. We're going to be talking to a few poster artists here today about how your band can take advantage of this medium, because it's great, has a very, very rich history. Let's learn a little more. All right, I am here with Charlie of Uncle Charlie. They've got a screen printing operation in Houston, and I wanted to talk to you a little bit about how you got your start in this. One of the things with our company is we make our gear very accessible to entry-level artists, and they might be interested in doing some of this themselves. So how'd you get started?
I got started in the mid-80s. I had a band out of Houston, Texas called Dresden 45.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And we did a lot of our own merchandise, of course. You know, it was all small scale. We did our own flyers for the advertised shows, and you know, back then, you know, that was prior to computers and internet and email, so everything was a little harder to try and network, not only in Houston, but in other cities to try and get shows and whatnot. But from there, as things started to develop, the flyers that developed into something that was kind of a collectible item. We would put flyers in record stores. People would take them down.
Mm-hmm.
Flyers on telephone poles before it was illegal.
Yeah.
People would take them down, you know, so it became difficult to really promote the show, because once they went up, they went down.
Right. I always made it a point when I collected flyers to wait until the show was over.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome. I would be like, no, it's March 18th. I'm not going to touch that because I want people to go to the show.
That's right. But then obviously a light bulb went off there, because we thought, well, gosh, you know, people are, they want the images on the flyers, so let's translate that image to a t-shirt.
Right on.
And then that became merchandise.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then we start to expand, okay, what other things can we sell that'll help promote the band? Well, stickers is a natural addition to a t-shirt. So we started to see cars with stickers of our bands on them, and we knew that the word was getting out.
Right on. Now, you mentioned that this all started, of course, pre-internet, pre-World Wide Web boom. I imagine that's, of course it's affected the way people market their bands.
Certainly.
But if one were to look around here, poster art is obviously thriving. But can you talk to me a little bit about the impact that the online revolution has had on this industry?
Yeah, the online revolution has really changed a lot of things, especially with just networking.
Right.
You know, it's a lot more accessible to hitting a greater audience at once.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know, whereas if we had a flyer on a telephone pole, we had to rely on people to drive by that telephone pole.
Exactly.
You know, or to go to that record store.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, in the early days, there was a fanzine called Maximum Rock and Roll out of San Francisco.
Oh, yeah.
And people used that as a networking tool. But again, with Facebook and websites, people can instantly see what's going on up to the date. In fact, you can almost cut down the time you have to promote the show.
Sure.
In other words, when we put out flyers for a show, we put them out at least 2 months in advance.
Okay.
And now you can do it 2 weeks in
mm-hmm,
advance
mm-hmm.
and still get a good turnout of the show.
Sure.
So it's more efficient.
You also talked about the collectability of this. You know, again, digital age changing everything. People are often getting the music for free.
Right.
But this is a good, you know, supplement to the music that people will pay for, because you can't download something tangible.
Exactly.
You know, so you can still sell it as merch at a show.
Yeah.
For bands that are interested in doing that, what's the best place to start? Like, what are the bare essential equipment that a young band might need to get started?
Yeah, sure. Well, you know, self-screening is a great way to get started. There's a lot of resources out there on the web where you can acquire self-screen equipment. And I'm going to plug a website.
It
has nothing to do with me, but
it's
called silkscreeningsupplies.com.
Okay.
And they've got a great entry-level kit called a hobby kit,
mm-hmm.
where they include everything. They include the frame, they include the film, they include the ink, the photo emulsion, even a DVD video on how you get started.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah. And it's just like a one-stop thing, one-stop shop deal. And you know, that's a great way to do it. Get your own frames, your film, and, mm-hmm. and you can do it in your garage. You can do it in your kitchen. You can, you know, it's a small thing. Doesn't take up a lot of room. Very easy to do.
Best to just jump in and get your hands dirty.
Jump in and get going. Yeah, yeah. I mean,
Charlie, thank you very much.
Hey, thank you, man.
Not gonna take any more of your time.
Appreciate it. No worries. All right, have a good one.
Thanks.